Well, now that I've started to actually try and use my layout a little bit, I've come up with, run into one little problem. Well, lots of them, but this is one that I think I figured out how to solve. Problem of where to put the throttles when you're not using them. That's kind of become the landing spot for them there. The only issue with that is that they keep falling off. So, come up with a solution I think should work. This little clamp unit here. You see? It fell off the pile. This little clamp unit here seems to be a reasonable solution. Let's just zoom in on that a little bit. Seems to hold it securely. Pops off, not too bad. Comes on, not too bad. Right. So, what is the source of my brilliant solution? Well, here is my solution. Dollar store selfie sticks. They're cheap. They grab on solidly. And don't need that part. They have just a standard 1/4 inch, 20 threads to the inch bolt thread there, which is cheap hardware store parts. So let's build one. Here's building it. One cheap dollar store selfie stick, which will never be used for a selfie. I'm actually doing the world a favor by removing selfie sticks from the environment. They're a bane. But for a dollar at the dollar store, I can use them for something that's actually helpful to the world. So this, I might actually just use that. I can clamp my camera onto things, and I have been doing that in some places. Just clamp that on there, put the camera on. Easy, I can put the camera in weird places. But that's not what I'm doing right now. That's just junk right now. So, get that off, don't need that. Now, what we do need is a bracket. So this is just like a little hardware store bracket, 4 for cheap. But I need to open it up. The holes are sized for number 8 or number 10 wood screw or something like that. So, I'm going to drill press. 1/4 inch bit. No surprise there. It is left-handed, what for the camera. There. Easy, simple. Done. Now then, 1/4 inch nut and bolt. The only reason I need the nut is because the bolts are longer than I wanted them to be, and I didn't feel like going and buying new stuff for this project, because I just happen to have these kicking around the house. Wow! See that? No wonder I wasn't using this for anything else. The slot isn't actually a physical slot. It's full of schmoo. Oh well, whatever. Not like I'm going to be holding up the roof with it or something. So, there you go. Just screw her together. Taking it down. There you go. That's all we need. Now, we'll get a wood screw, screw it on. So now it's just a matter of installing it. I'm putting them here so that they're protected from stray wandering hips when you're coming through. They're somewhat underneath the layout. They're easy to grab, convenient, not going anywhere. Easy, simple, done. Now just to build 2 more for the other throttles. Right then, there's the 3 of them mounted there, the 3 UT1s. ensuring the throttles that I use 90% of the time because they're just dead simple. And the fourth one, creaky pan, I mounted over there. The booster is mounted up underneath. And because this is a really old Digitrack system, it's one of the first Loconet systems. It's the Big Boy, I think they called it. So this DT200 throttle there is actually the command station, which means it has to stay plugged in all the time. So I try not to use it as a throttle as such. I'll use it for programming and stuff like that, but it needs to stay plugged in so it doesn't move around. So I've put it close to the booster and close to the switch that switches the programming track on and off. And there it is, and it's underneath and out of the way.